Onward Skills Russia. I'm Deputy Director General and I'm Technical Delegate in World Skills Community from Russia. Thank you everyone for attending this meeting. It will be very informative for you. So just a short communication rules. Please mute yourself if you are not speaking. Also for those who would like to have a chance to look some this presentation later can use link for YouTube. And also we will have translation and our interpreter is here. However, we will make it in consequent way because a few colleagues in some countries asked us to share the records. So when we are making a recording, it's better when we have consequent translation. So here you are at our sessions regarding World Skills Russia national competitions. So today we have our meeting regarding online skills assessment. Our experts will share with you our experience. And here is our plan for today. When we plan this meeting, we would like to share with you different solutions and different findings, which our experts find based on their experience and based on the skills. Here we can see that we have how we can assess when we have special testing site in Skills Center, how we can, there was a lot of questions regarding how we can assess social and personal services skills when a lot of judgment are there. It was a lot of questions, how can we are going to organize assessment of such skills when we will need details. And also, there are some solutions regarding online platforms and clouds. And then if you have questions, please type these questions in the chat and then we will answer you. So now I would like to give the word to Daniil Ufimtsev. Let me share his presentation. And what is important for us that when Russia got the challenge with pandemic, we were, as most of the countries, at our final examination at the college. And it was a challenge for us how to proceed with final examination. And in Russia, we use World Skills standards and World Skills formats for final assessment. So before we decide to run our national competition in hybrid format, online and venue format, we have been pilot a lot of different solutions through our final examinations. So Daniil, are you here with us? Let's connect Daniil. He is here. I have seen him.
Hello.
Yes, here's Daniil. So I will share the screen and Daniil will tell you the information.
Presentация, коллеги.
Just a moment, just a second, Daniil.
Okay.
You can start, Daniil, можешь начать.
Окей. Коллеги, добрый всем день. Рад всех приветствовать в рамках деловой программы на финале национального чемпионата «Молодые профессионалы World Skills Россия». 2020.
Hello, dear colleagues. I'm glad to greet you here at the conference program of the National Competition 2020.
Я бы хотел осветить уникальный опыт Российской Федерации с точки зрения внедрения демонстрационного экзамена по стандартам WorldSkills Россия.
So I'd like to share the unique experience of the Russian Federation, which is about the integration of the demonstration exam according to the WorldSkills standards.
Союз WorldSkills России, являясь оператором международной организации WorldSkills International на территории Российской Федерации, реализует ряд инициатив, в том числе одной из инициатив является внедрение оценки качества подготовки кадров в соответствии с передовыми технологиями и международными стандартами среди студентов и выпускников образовательных организаций среднего профессионального образования.
So WorldSkills Russia, being the operator of the WorldSkills International, does a series of initiatives, including the integration of demonstration exams, using all the latest equipment and digital technologies for the vocational education and trainings.
Сутевой частью модели внедрения демонстрационного экзамена стали некие базовые принципы качества подготовки, оценки качества подготовки кадров в соответствии с этими, с международными стандартами.
So the basic principles of the integration of the demonstration exam became the professional quality preparation of the professionals of the vocational education and trainings.
Но ключевым для нас в целом, для Российской Федерации, стало то, что WorldSkills как оператор проведения демонстрационного экзамена стал уникальная практика появилась по внедрению единых оценочных материалов, и это для нас является ключевой системой с точки зрения внедрения демонстрационного экзамена и оценки качества подготовки кадров.
So the key moment for the Russian Federation for the integration of the demonstration exam became the integration of general assessment criteria for all the exams.
Второй момент – это то, что мы предъявляем единые требования к материально-технической базе. Это позволяет как раз-таки образовательной организации, колледжи, техникумы переориентировать на современное оборудование для подготовки высококвалифицированных специалистов для экономики Российской Федерации.
So the second thing is that we ask special criteria for all the materials and equipment, and that gives an opportunity for all the vocational trainings and schools to have the latest technologies.
Демонстрационный экзамен мы позиционируем как независимую оценку, в целом как независимую оценку, и здесь мы третьим базовым принципом для себя обозначаем экспертное сообщество. Оно у нас делится на несколько категорий. Есть эксперты, которые выступают администраторами и осуществляют определенные работы в цифровой платформе. А есть эксперты, которые привлекаются непосредственно с предприятий, с заказчиков подготовки кадров, которые как раз-таки обеспечивают эту независимую оценку подготовки кадров.
So, speaking about the demonstration exam, it became the independent assessment criteria. And here we have experts community and different types of experts. First of all, these are administration experts who are doing some paperwork and filling in the information. And in other parts of experts, they do the assessment itself.
Для нас важно было реализовать демонстрационный экзамен, и мы его вот буквально за короткий промежуток времени масштабировали, и очевидно было, что для масштабирования демонстрационного экзамена нам нужны современные инструменты управления, коим у нас на сегодняшний день выступает цифровая платформа, которая обеспечивает автоматизацию подготовки и проведения демонстрационного экзамена.
So it was important for us to integrate the demonstration exam and to put it to a larger scale. And what was important to have a special tooling, which was the digital platform for us now, and that gives us an opportunity to integrate the demonstration exam.
Ну и ключевой, это базовый принцип, это, наверное, результат образовательной деятельности, который выражается skills passport, skills passport.
I'm sorry.
Да, хорошо.
We had a sound problem. Данил, вас не было слышно.
Пятым базовым элементом выступает у нас skills passport, который выступает в качестве документа, отражающего результаты практической подготовки и непосредственно профессиональных навыков и квалификации выпускника.
So the fifth element of our principles is the skills passport, which is to reflect the professional skills and qualifications of the graduate.
Ну и, конечно же, этот документ для нас является уникальным. Мы его позиционируем как международная инициатива, и продвижение происходит и на внутреннем рынке, так скажем, среди российских компаний.
So, of course, this initiative is really important for us, and we propose it as an international initiative, and we're also trying here inside Russia to promote this skills passport.
Это, наверное, ну и если говорить о российском рынке, то сейчас демонстрационный экзамен признали более 600 российских компаний. Это как крупный, средний, малый бизнес, который работает как и на международном рынке, так и на российском.
So speaking about Russia, we have about 600 companies that have proved that that skills passport is a real thing, and these companies are large scale ones and that are involved in the international trade.
Это, наверное, базовая модель, которая дальше, на которой все строится с точки зрения организации проведения демонстрационного экзамена.
So basically, that's the model that we are using for integrating the demonstration exam.
Теперь непосредственно хотелось бы перейти уже к неким деталям и очень быстро про ним пройтись.
So right now, I would like to tell you a little bit in detail.
Первое, ну это собственно динамика проведения демонстрационного экзамена. Второй слайд. Можно, пожалуйста, это включить. Здесь, ну, не буду останавливаться. Понятно, что мы с этим проектом в российских колледжах и техникумах растем, но та пандемия и те условия, которые у нас появились, внесли свои коррективы.
So now I'm speaking a little bit about the dynamics of the demonstration exam in Russia. We are trying to promote this project here, but unfortunately, the pandemic situation in the world has changed it a little bit.
Следующий слайд. Здесь бы я хотел обратить внимание, что у нас образование, оно через инструмент демонстрационного экзамена идет непосредственно в связке с бизнесом.
So here I would like to mention that education system using the demonstration exam is closely connected to business.
Ну, пару комментариев тоже по поводу бизнеса. Здесь мы используем те международные стандарты, которые имеются, и также у нас есть инструменты сборки видов профессиональной деятельности в компетенции, внедрения их в демонстрационные экзамены и в чемпионаты. И здесь основными заказчиками у нас выступает бизнес, а не система образования. Это, на мой взгляд, важный момент, который бы я хотел отметить.
So speaking about this connection, we are trying to follow the international standards, and it's important to mention that we refer to the business requirements, not about the educational system.
Следующий слайд. Ну, на следующем слайде у нас показано непосредственно те условия и элементы, как мы используем некую цифровизацию и адаптацию при проведении демонстрационного экзамена, и мы достаточно в короткие сроки адаптируемся под реальные условия, которые складываются в нашей жизни.
So here in this slide you can see the conditions and elements for conducting the demonstration exam in the realities that we have now.
На следующем слайде, связанный с нормативно-правовой базой, я хотел бы отметить о том, что мы достаточно синхронизированно выстраиваем логику нормативно-правовой базы на те вызовы, которые у нас появляются. И в частности, Министерство просвещения Российской Федерации, которое регулирует нормативно-правовую базу колледжей и техникумов, с учетом опыта WorldSkills утвердило особенности проведения аттестации.
So, now speaking about the regulatory documents, we are trying to adapt the regulatory documents to the current reality, and especially now the Ministry of Education and Science of the Russian Federation has adapted one law on the educational programs and educational institutions, distance learning technologies.
Следующий слайд, это, собственно, слайд про Skills Passport. Мы его модернизировали, адаптировали с точки зрения большего погружения относительно стандартов WorldSkills. Сейчас в нем отражается непосредственно сам стандарт WorldSkills и непосредственные модули. И здесь я хотел бы отметить о том, что еще раз о том, что у нас продвижение этого документа как продукта оценки происходит на как международном, так и на российском уровне.
So again, speaking about the skills passport, it reflects the standards of world skills. And I would like to mention once again that we are trying to promote it both inside the country and outside.
Следующий слайд. Непосредственно понятно, что изначально на первом слайде я обозначил ключевым для нас при проведении демонстрационных экзаменов является оценочные материалы, то есть что мы проверяем. И здесь важно, что это разрабатывается не самими образовательными организациями, кто как хочет, а непосредственно на федеральном уровне.
So, as I already mentioned, the key was the assessment material for us, and what is important that not all the vocational and training schools are proving the materials of assessment, but it's done governmentally.
И за достаточно короткий срок мы, благодаря нашему экспертному сообществу, смогли провести работу по адаптации содержания оценочных материалов для того, чтобы их можно было применить в дистанционном формате проведения демонстрационного экзамена.
So in a short period of time, thanks to our expert community, we had a chance to adapt all the assessment materials to the integration of demonstration exam in a distant format.
Ну и здесь есть некая статистика с точки зрения цифр по форматам дистанционного экзамена. У нас здесь есть разные форматы, когда участники и эксперты сдавали из дома, это 32 компетенции, когда только эксперты осуществляли оценку из дома и участникам надо было приходить на площадке.
So here we see the statistics, basically these are digits. For example, we have 32 people that were taking the exam, and the experts were assessing it from home.
Ну и, собственно, к результатам. Восьмой слайд непосредственно про объемы экзаменов в разрезе способов проведения демонстрационного экзамена. И здесь у нас есть определенный некий рейтинг компетенций. Здесь у нас есть цифры с точки зрения форматов демонстрационного экзамена. Но в совокупности, если сказать среднюю цифру, то у нас около 25% демонстрационных экзаменов от общего объема состоял в дистанционном формате. И это было сделано примерно за 1.5-2 месяца.
So speaking about the methods of the demonstration exam and the results that we've achieved, here you can see the list of the skills. And in general, we had about 25% of all the demonstration exams that were done in a distant format.
Следующий слайд. Ну, я здесь хочу сказать о том, что нельзя однозначно говорить о том, что все компетенции в дистанционном формате имеют высокие результаты. Или наоборот, что когда студент приходит на площадку, у него результаты выше, чем нежели он сдает из дома. Мы видим в ряде компетенций, что когда участник сдает из дома, у него результаты выше, и наоборот.
So I cannot say that we have any tendency here, because sometimes, for example, when the competitor is doing the demonstration exam in a remote format, he has a higher result than he, for example, would be doing that in a face-to-face format.
На мой взгляд, такая статистика и такие результаты говорят о жизнеспособности дистанционного формата демонстрационного экзамена.
So in my opinion, these results are showing the real idea of the demonstration exam that it's possible to be in a distant format.
Ну и буквально последний слайд, наверное, он не менее интересный с точки зрения какие же мы интернет-решения или ресурсы использовали с точки зрения проведения демонстрационных экзаменов. Понятно, что мы сейчас стоим на этапе того, чтобы у нас был какой-то централизованный ресурс для того, чтобы обеспечить качество подготовки и проведения демонстрационного экзамена. Но, тем не менее, еще раз напомню, у нас достаточно был ограниченный срок, и мы пошли по пути максимальной вариативности использования ресурсов.
So now speaking about the software and internet solutions that were used for the integration of the demonstration exam, and we were trying to create one center source, but I would like to mention that we were in a short period of time. That is why these are the solutions that we were using.
И многообразие различных инструментов и те результаты, которые мы получаем, впечатляет нас надежду и веру в то, что мы можем двигаться дальше и развиваться. У меня все. Спасибо большое за внимание.
So the number of tooling and solutions that we had and all the results that we achieved gave us hope that we can somehow develop this distant format of the demonstration exams. Thank you for your attention. That's all.
Thank you, Daniil. Thank you for the work which have been done from WorldSkills Russia side and your department, and thank you for all the work of the experts. So Daniil show us the overview how with what kind of challenge we have forced, and that it was very important for us just in a few months to find the way how to make distance and format for our final examination. And now I would like to share with you how we are trying to manage this competition format in distant way. Just a moment. So I will show you very short how the key points like at WorldSkills we have our skills management team, and you can see that for online and distant format we have to change some functions of our skills management team. So I would like to tell thank you to our experts who prepare this presentation. Елена Шпаковская, she is here and she will tell you more information about hairdressing. So now you can see that we have skills management team, not just at the venue, how we usually we have at WorldSkills. We have our skills management team as well as the workshop. So we can see that we have our competition management center. You have been experienced to see competition management center yesterday. And also we have our colleges, our venues. So now we have more additional function and more additional people. So the most important, like for hybrid format, we develop competition rules. Also each skill develop skill specific competition rules for remote format. We will share this during our skill by skill sessions. Also, you can see that, of course, chief expert for us is the one who is responsible for the competition in general. Also, chief experts and deputy chief experts have access to the CIS and manage with CIS because we use CIS for all our skills. And also, chief experts and deputy have access to all video and all recordings. And they're also responsible for all the forms which have to be filled. And now we can see the most interesting, like what does Compatriot Expert is doing, because Compatriot Expert cannot attend the competition venue because his competitor is taking part. And it's important that there is no communication during competition with Compatriot Expert. So Compatriot Expert is not at the venue where is his competitors, but Compatriot Expert have access to platform and can watch all the videos and photographs and some IT solutions from IT skills and make assessment of other competitors. And also through this video access, he can see when some issues or breaches of the rules happened. So he are fixing it and then experts later come back to this. Also, why we need independent assessment experts? There was a lot of discussion in World Skills community regarding independent assessment experts, and now we need these people a lot. So these people are from the industry and they help us from one hand for, especially for judgment. And also this independent assessment experts have function of audit. So they are checking for some measurements and some judgments which have been done by the experts online. Also, workshop manager now have not just a function to develop infrastructure. And now we don't have just one work manager. We have a workshop manager at all our venues. And workshop manager not just responsible for renting infrastructure, but they're also responsible for all digital stories and for all cameras and for all videos. So here is the basic information regarding how we arrange our competition, how we change regulations and how we change communication between key important people at the venue. And now I would like to give the word to Alexei. He will, from one hand, he will show in general how drywall system are managed with online competition. And also he will make some really great points regarding ideas and in assessment. Alexei.
Здравствуйте, коллеги. Меня зовут Алексей. Я являюсь экспертом по компетенции сухое строительство и штукатурные работы.
Hello, dear colleagues. My name is Alexey. I'm an expert from drywall and plastering systems.
Для проведения... Для проведения чемпионата в дистанционном формате нам важно подготовить рабочее место конкурсанта и правильно расположить камеры.
So it was important for us to conduct the national competition to prepare the workstation of the competitor and also to have a right camera layout.
На данном слайде продемонстрированы расположение, примерное расположение камер и план застройки площадки.
So in this slide you can see the approximate camera layout and also the workshop installation plan.
Для более качественного проведения чемпионата в данном формате нам требуется 6 камер.
So we need 6 cameras to have a proper format in this distant format competition.
Одна камера устанавливается общего вида.
So one camera gives a general view.
4 камеры захватывают 4 стороны площадки.
So 4 cameras gives 4 views of the sides of the workshop.
Они работают в круглосуточном режиме 24 часа.
So they work 24 hours.
6-я камера переносная с функцией передачи звука микрофона.
So camera number 6 is a movable one, and it also has audio recording.
Она нам нужна для оценки, чтобы камера передвигалась вместе с оценивающими экспертами.
So we need this camera for assessment and marking so that the assessment expert can move this camera with him.
Также нам потребуется смартфон для двусторонней связи с экспертами и центром управления.
So we also need a smartphone so that we can connect the experts and connect with the competition management center.
В нашей компетенции требуется более большая площадь для проведения чемпионата, поэтому некоторые колледжи используют для этого спортзал.
So for our skill, we need a large area so that some of the vocational institutions, they are using the gym.
Также на данном слайде продемонстрирован обзор камер одного из чемпионатов.
So here in this slide you can also see the layout of the cameras from one of the competitions.
Следующий этап – это приемка площадки компетенции.
So now we are going to speak about the workshop admission.
Центр управления компетенции принимает площадку у технического администратора и экспертов, работающих на площадке.
So, workshop manager and technical staff who is working at the workshop in some place is giving this workshop to the competition management center.
Проверяет готовность площадки согласно инфраструктурному листу.
So we are checking the readiness of the workstation according to the infrastructure list.
И плану застройки.
And the layout plan.
Также через двустороннюю связь проводится регистрация экспертов и участников.
So using the two-side connection, we are registering the experts and the competitors.
Эксперты и участники подходят к камере и делают фиксацию с паспортом, как указано на данном слайде.
So competitors and experts, they come up to the camera, you can see that in the slide, with a passport.
Далее участники заносят тулбоксы на площадку.
Then competitors put the toolbox inside the walking area.
Эксперты проверяют его.
So experts are assessing these toolboxes.
И после чего участник ничего не может донести в рабочую зону.
And after this moment, the competitor cannot bring anything else to the walking area.
Участники и эксперты должны быть в специальной одежде и соблюдать технику безопасности и охраны труда.
So all the competitors and experts are to have personal protective equipment and to follow the health and safety regulations.
Оценка проводится по завершению модуля. Конкурсант покидает площадку.
And we do the assessment and marking after the module finishes, and the competitor is to leave the workstation.
Эксперты, находящиеся на площадке, производят замеры.
So experts who are in the workshop do the measurement.
При этом пользуясь переносной камерой.
And in this very moment they're using the movable camera.
Заполняют оценочную ведомость.
So they fill out the marking list.
По заполнению ведомости технический администратор площадки делает фотографию и с помощью мессенджера отправляет в центр управления компетенцией.
So when the experts are done with the marking and they filled out the marking sheet, the workshop manager takes a photo of this sheet and send this via WhatsApp.
Также в качестве платформы файла обмена используем систему Moodle и Messenger WhatsApp.
And also for sharing the files, we're using Moodle and WhatsApp.
В Moodle эксперты подгружают документацию и фотографии по чемпионату.
Using the Moodle platform, experts send the files and documentation.
Через WhatsApp идет обмен фотоматериалами оценки и оценочных ведомостей.
So using WhatsApp, experts send photo materials for assessment and marking sheets.
Для улучшения качества работы на площадке были разработаны чек-листы для технического администратора площадки.
So we've designed special checklists for the workshop manager to improve the quality of work.
Где описаны основные действия на площадке.
So in this checklist, you can see the main actions for the workshop manager and his work at the workshop.
Например, принести защитную обувь, подготовить оборудование к трансляции и так далее.
For example, bring safety shoes and prepare the equipment for broadcasting, etc.
Также чек-лист для экспертов, находящихся на площадке.
We also have checklists for the experts who are on site.
Чек-лист для эксперта, находящегося в центре управления.
Also checklist for the experts who are in the competition management center.
И чек-лист для конкурсанта.
And also one checklist for the competitor.
Представлены примеры оценочных ведомостей и их заполнение, правильного заполнения.
So here in this slide you can see a sample of a marking form and how to fill out it properly.
Эксперт центра управления проводит инструктаж по
so
данной.
The experts who are the competition management center give briefing how to fill out this marking form.
Также выдвигаются требования к контрольно-измерительному инструменту.
So also we give some requirements for the tooling, for measurement.
Контрольно-измерительный инструмент также проверяется на видеофиксацию.
So these measurement tools we are also checking with the help of a photo.
И разработаны фотографии, слайды, видеозаписи по корректному использованию контрольно-измерительному инструменту.
And also we have samples or like a photo ones, how to use a measuring instrument tools.
На данном слайде указано фото центра управления.
So in this slide you can see how the competition management center looks.
Где установлены большие мониторы. We и можно просматривать рабочие места.
So you can see large monitors here on which you can see the workshops of the competitors.
После того, как площадка была принята экспертами, составляется акт готовности площадки и загружается в систему Moodle.
So when the workstation was admitted by the experts, we prepare a special protocol, and this protocol is sent to the Moodle platform.
На данном слайде указано, приведены примеры с чемпионата оценки экспертов. Каждый аспект делается фотофиксация и направляется в ЦУС.
So here you can see the assessment process of one of the competition. This way we are taking photos of each measurement and all these photos are sent to the competition management center.
Линейные размеры, уровни горизонтали, горизонтальности, вертикальность, чтобы эксперты убедились в корректности измерения.
So linear measurement and also horizontal and vertical level, so that experts can be sure that the measurement was correct.
После, как и говорилось ранее, каждая ведомость фотографируется и отправляется, заполненная с тремя подписями, отправляется в центр управления.
So as I have already mentioned, after filling out this marking form, we put three signatures on it, and then we send it to the competition management center.
Эксперт, находящийся в центре управления, заносит данные оценки в систему CIS.
And the expert who is at the competition management center puts all this information to the CIS.
Большое спасибо за внимание.
That is all. Thank you for your attention.
Все. Спасибо.
Алексей, thank you very much. It was really great presentation, and your experience is one of the best. So for all the experts who are here, you can see that when we have the possibility to measure some aspects, especially with tools which we have provided to all distributed venues, the most important is to develop these instructions regarding all measurement and have photo and video how to measure. So the expert who is like an independent expert assessor at the venue may call the measurement. The person who are in management control central navigate the people who are at the venue how to make these measures, and then all the measures come to CIS through competition management center. So the same we developed with all other skills when it's possible to measure. However, we have sometimes some cases when the equipment is very expensive, like when we make some laser technology and when people make coding and then they have to check it. And also like example with our drone operating, when we need quite a big site to check how drones operating. So here we have experts in drone operating. Svetlana, could you share please experience how you manage with your skill, because you develop a special zone for testing in one of our skills centers, and through online technology we provide this access to the center to all competitors. Svetlana, are you with us?
Yeah. Hi everyone. Thanks Alina for your introduction, and now I'm going to share my screen. Yes, it's okay. So, hello everyone. My name is Svetlana Slomatnikova, and I'm expert in drone operating skill. And today I will tell you about our remote venue in drone operating in the remote format, how to provide it. And also I will tell you some words about our skill. So, let's start. First of all, I would like to make some statistics of our drone operating skill community. So now we have more than 500 active members from 16 countries in the world. and it includes participants and members from the community, from schools, colleges, universities, and other companies. And according to WorldSkills framework, we provided more than 100 events. And average age of our community member, it's 23 years. Also, I would like to tell you about our system of education. WorldSkills Russia combined educational organizations such as school, colleges, universities, and industries. And industry help has a more influence on this system, and it helps to provide actual tasks from industry. It's a motivated educational organization to update their curriculums, provide research activities, and involvement of school children, and provide blue-collar growth. So in the remote format, we provide two international events named camps. It was a Future Skills Camp in July and Asia Skills in August. So online format help us to combine, to join more participants, to involve new members who are interested in drones. And we provide skills camps for more than 80 participants from 12 countries. And our products, we have a community. And also we have a video tutorials, which you can see and use. It's open using Future Skills channel. And this experience help us to provide a big events, WorldSkills Russia National Competition. In our drone operating skill, will be participated 37 competitors from the more than 14 regions of Russia. And also this competition will be include different categories of age. It's for college students from 16 and up to 22nd years old, juniors, more popular category in our drone operating skill, 14 regions from Russia. And also in the national competition will be participate juniors from 12 and up to 14 years old. And according and during our national competition, we have international guests from Ecuador, Ghana, United Arab Emirates, Kazakhstan, and Malaysia. Some words about our test project. So we have, in online format, we have four models of tasks. So for main category for college students, it includes autonomous flight coding, FPV piloting, multi-copter diagnostic and repair it, and monitoring. For another ages categories, we stay only three models, and for foreign international participants, they will compete with using they will compete, provide the task with autonomous flight coding and FPV piloting using a simulator. So next I will tell you about each model, how we will provide it in online format, and how we will assess it, how we will provide assessment. First of all, this is an example of our remote venue. So we have a remote venue with the flight zone and with technical support, technical site with laptops, with cameras, which provided our live stream. and teams from another regions, from another countries, connect to the remote venue using Zoom and Telegram platform for quick communication. So also this flight zone equipped with drones and with experts who provide assessment, who provide technical support for this venue. So first of all, I would like to tell you about monitoring task. It includes flight drones via internet and provide some tasks such as to recognize any objects or make a photo of a map of the flight zone. Also, we sometimes we use a thermal camera to recognize different objects and to determine their temperature. All flight control will be performed via internet and via video streaming on the camera. Assessments will be provided using a report which competitor will be prepared after the flight. Report include photos and description of it. Next model, it's a diagnostic and repair of drone. First of all, competitors need to provide, need to perform a test in online format. And after that, they will give different video and photo materials with errors of drones. And so for example, like this. Yeah, this is an error of connection, and competitors need to create this report where he needs to describe, to provide description of the error or fault and provide solution of this problem. Next model and FPV flight using a simulator. So it seems like this. Competitors using their remote control connect to their to the track in the simulation and provide FPV flight using their laptop only. And after finishing provided of this track, competitors need to send screenshots of their best track to the mission control center. It can be looks like this, and this is a remote control, and this is a simulation. So expert will be assessment using a video recording or screenshots of the flight. And finally, the most difficult model of our competition, it's of course autonomous flight programming, because autonomous drones is the future and today's of our trends in development. And we suggest to solve a task according to this situation, such as COVID and pandemic time. So competitors need to program a drone which help to recognize people who have a sickness. And also they need to determine type of this sickness, for example, healthy, COVID or non-COVID. So it seems like this. Competitors need to recognize QR codes and determine any color of the polygon. Here you can see about our test site, and here you can see how it looks from the competitor side. So we provide live stream where competitors can see about venue. Also, they have a window with a flight zone where drone perform a flight. This is a view from camera of drone. And here it is a terminal where some information will be posted and competitors can read it and fix different backlogs of their drone. And also experts using these materials, using data, using videos from the drones, and finally expert will give a report. They provided a remote assessment of the performance task. So thank you for your attention, and feel free to ask me on the email or phone or Telegram. Thank you very much.
Titania, thank you very much. This is really great experience and one of the good cases. We also even like we have robotic welding and also have simulations. And also some other skills develop different online platforms with simulations. And this idea with Polygon is also great. So it means that not just all Russian regions can use this site, but also other countries. And we already have experience to have some training camps in future skills and in most popular skills. And with all this possibility, it really works. And our competitors in progress, experts in progress, and also we are looking for possibility to have such kind of models for trainings in education. And for the next speakers, I would like to introduce you Elena Shpakovskaya. She is our expert in hairdressing. There are a lot of questions about how it's possible to assess online creative skills and social and career skills when there are a lot of judgment aspects and a lot of discussions, even during the competition, like the skills are the last one which are finished, and sometimes experts until very late night at the venue. So Yelena, could you please share your experience?
Thank you, Alina. Hello, everyone. Nice to see you here. I'm very glad to have the opportunity to share our experience with you. Let me speak Russian. Итак, начнем. В августе 2020 года наша компетенция имела первый опыт проведения дистанционного чемпионата. И именно этот опыт дал нам возможность хорошо подготовиться к проведению финала национального чемпионата, потому что компетенция многочисленная, и в отборочных соревнованиях в нашей компетенции принимало участие 54 региона, 54 участника.
So in August 2020, we had the first time experience of organizing the competition in a distant format, and this opportunity gave us a chance to get ready for the finals of the national competition in September, because our skill always has a large number of participants, and this time it was 54 regions.
Итак, по итогу отборочных соревнований на финал было отобрано 12 участников, которые представляют все федеральные округа Российской Федерации.
So in the end, after the competition in August, we have chosen 12 competitors who are representing all federal regions of the Russian Federation.
На следующем слайде вы можете увидеть название регионов участников. Это большая честь для всех ребят принять участие в новом формате чемпионата. И большой интерес для нас самих в проведении подобного формата. Конечно, подобный формат не дает нам такого живого общения, к сожалению, но вместе с тем это хороший опыт, это новые технологии, которые возможно применять и продвигать новые технологии, несмотря на все вызовы и сложности, которые появляются в нашей жизни.
So in this slide you can see the regions from which the competitors are coming to the competition, and it was a big honor for all of them to participate in such a competition in a distant format. And for us, it was also a very interesting experience to have a competition in a distant format. And it, of course, it's different a little bit from the face-to-face communication, and we are missing it. But anyway, it's a chance for using the new technologies and the integration of new technologies in a real life situation, despite all the challenges that life is giving to us.
Для проведения финала национального чемпионата компетенция не изменила объема задания, и тест-проджект выглядит ровно так же, как он был запланирован еще зимой этого года. То есть он содержит все семь заявленных модулей, как и было запланировано.
So for the finals of the national competition in a distant format, we haven't changed the test project, and it looks absolutely the same that it was supposed to look when we planned it in winter 2020. So we have seven complete modules here.
Общее время выполнения конкурсного задания составляет 17 часов 40 минут. Другими словами, наши участники, так же как и на живом чемпионате, будут выполнять свои работы в течение 4 дней.
So the total time for doing the test project is 17 hours 40 minutes, and just the same as in a real life competition, all the competitors will do the test project for 4 days.
Аналогично коллегам из других компетенций, организация площадки конкурсной в нашей компетенции построена по тому же принципу. То есть с помощью установленных веб-камер на определенных точках центр управления чемпионатом и эксперты на местах следят за проведением и ходом работы.
Speaking about the workshop installation, we've used the same experience as all the other colleagues from different other skills. We have, first of all, cameras to look after the competitor. Also, we have experts on site and experts in the competition management center.
Для того, чтобы всем экспертам было удобно работать и все функции были понятны каждому, наша Skills Team разработала методические рекомендации по проведению оценки.
So to make the work convenient for everyone, for all the experts, our Skills Management Team created one methodological recommendation for all the experts.
Итак, оценка работы участников, несмотря на изменение формата, фактически не изменилась сама по себе. Она также включает в себя измерительную оценку и судейскую.
Despite the changes in the format, we mean the distant one, the marking scheme hasn't changed. We have measurement and judgment.
Маленькое отличие measurement'а, оценки измеримой, в том, что наша Skills Team, получив опыт проведения предыдущих соревнований, пришла к выводу о том, что большую часть оценки необходимо выводить в фотографии, в оценке по фотографиям.
So, referring to the experience that we've gained in the previous competition in August, our skills management team made a slight difference in the measurement, and we've decided that it would be better to use photos for doing the measurement.
Оценка в области нарушений, которые может допустить участник, выполняется следующим образом. Нет, пока рано. Что касается нарушений, эксперты, компатриоты получают право доступа к видеозаписи работы участников других регионов.
So speaking about the violations of the competitors, the mistakes that they are doing, compatriot experts are given access to the recordings of the competitors of different other regions.
Внимательно наблюдают за работой участника и фиксируют допущенные нарушения с обязательством остановкой на минуте этого нарушения, то есть минута обязательно фиксируется.
So these very competitive experts are supervising the work of the competitor. When they see a mistake or a violation, they write down it, they write it down and put the time of the violation.
И после завершения модуля документы, то есть протоколы, в которых указаны минуты с нарушениями, обязательно проверяются в центре управления соревнованиями, главным экспертом.
So, for example, when the module is finished, all these protocols with violations and mistakes is sent to the competition management center, where experts again assess that.
И в том случае, если это нарушение действительно было допущено, оно фиксируется как нарушение.
And in case this violation was really made, it's put like a violation by the experts in the competition management center.
Все остальные аспекты субкритериев фиксируются на основании выполненных фотографий в определенные точки стоп.
So all the other aspects of the subcriteria is measured, assessed using the photos at the stop points.
Что такое точки стоп? Это обязательные остановки в процессе выполнения работ, которые указываются в методических рекомендациях.
So what are the stop points? These are obligatory stops that are in the methodological recommendations.
На которых технический администратор площадки обязан сделать фотографии по заявленным аспектам.
So when the competitor reaches the stop point, the workshop manager is to take photos.
И после выполнения этих фотографий технический администратор площадки сразу отправляет выполненные фотосъемку на определенный веб-ресурс, которым пользуется компетенция.
And after these photos are taken, the workshop manager immediately sends these photos to the web source, which is used by the skill.
Также выполняются следующий слайд, Алина, пожалуйста. Даны рекомендации всем участникам, техническим администраторам площадки, каким образом необходимо фотографировать, с каких ракурсов выполненную работу для того, чтобы было возможно провести измеримую оценку.
So we also give recommendations to all the competitors and all the workshop managers. We give the angle from which the competitor is supposed to take a photo so that we are able to do the measurement.
Самое интересное, что этими фотографиями в том числе могут воспользоваться и независимые оценщики, которые выполняют судейскую оценку.
So the most interesting thing is that independent experts, assessment experts who are doing the independent marking are also can also use these photos.
Следующий слайд. Еще один из видов фотографий, которые в нашей компетенции должны выполнять участники, это фотография сходства заданию.
So one more thing that the competitor is supposed to do is to take a photo so that his final result coincides with the test project.
В том случае, если компетенция выбирает секретное задание, участники получают это задание от технического администратора за 15 минут до начала старта.
And in case the skill management team chooses the secret task, the competitor gets the secret task from a workshop manager 15 minutes earlier before the start of the module.
Сами технические администраторы получают это задание единовременно, независимо от региона, где находится участник, и с центра управления соревнованиями.
So we send this secret task from the competition management center to all the workshop managers at the same time, independently from the time zone.
Таким образом, все участники соревнований любого часового пояса, где бы ни находился регион, в одно и то же время получают секретное задание и начинают к нему готовиться.
So, no matter in which time zone the competitor is, everyone gets the secret task at the same time, and they have equal time for the preparation.
В методических рекомендациях также прописаны требования к качеству фотографии, которые должны выполнять технические администраторы, с условием того, что если качество фотографии будет неудовлетворительное, не будет четкости, точности, или еще какие-то параметры не будут соблюдены, то такие работы не будут рассматриваться для оценки.
The methodological recommendations also have requirements to the quality of the photos, and we've mentioned that if the photos, for example, have poor quality, and such kind of photos are not going to be assessed.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Оценка judgment, судейская оценка. Соблюдена полностью в соответствии с международными стандартами оценки WorldSkills, содержит самый широкий круг аспектов для оценки, и на оценке судейской работают независимые оценщики.
So speaking about the judgment, it corresponds to the international standards, WorldSkills international standard, and for judgment we use the independent experts.
И для того, чтобы была возможность удобной, спокойной работы для оценщиков из разных регионов, нами была разработана система заполнения оценки в Excel-форме на Google диске.
In order to make this judgment marking convenient for all the assessment experts who live in different time zones, we created a special method using the Excel Google form so that they can fill out all the criteria here.
Таким образом, каждый оценщик имеет право редактирования входа в таблицу, он имеет возможность доступа к ресурсу с фотографиями участников, просматривает все фотографии работ и выставляет свою оценку в Excel-форме, Excel-таблице.
So this way the independent assessment expert have a chance to enter the Google Documents, he has a chance to look through the photos, to assess them, and to fill in the marking form, and just to send it.
Соответственно, главный эксперт чемпионата имеет доступ к этой таблице, и после определенного времени, которое было назначено для проведения оценки, эксперт, главный эксперт получает оценку от всех членов судейской команды.
And of course, the chief expert has access to this Excel document, and after the appointed time, after which he is going to get the result from all the independent assessment experts.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. И таким образом в методических рекомендациях даны также образцы выполнения фотографий по готовому завершенному результату. На слайде вы видите пример этих фотографий, которые должны демонстрировать готовую работу со всех ракурсов.
So methodological recommendations also include sample photos for taking photos of the result of the test project. And in this slide, you can see all the photos that the competitor is supposed to take from different angles and the aspects of the finished look required for judgment.
И заключительный слайд, на котором вы можете видеть схему оценки, которая была разработана для проведения отборочного чемпионата, и которая будет применяться на финале национального чемпионата.
So in this slide you can see the marking scheme that was developed for the competition in August, and this very marking scheme we are going to use for the finals of the national competition.
В этой таблице мы можем увидеть соотношение распределения баллов по отношению к стандарту спецификации навыков All Skills.
So in this very table you can see the mark allocation according to the specification standards of World Skills.
На этом я закончила. Спасибо большое всем.
So that is all. Thank you very much for your attention.
Елена, thank you for such detailed explanation. It's really great that you share your experience. And it's really great that you're following World Skills standard, even this period, and with this all online technologies. I think that also Elena mentioned the most important, that detailed recommendations are very important. We have already discussed at competition committee and technical committee previously about how we have to prepare it, methodology and documents and guidance for assessment. And I think especially now all this guidance are very important, and for Skills Russia now have a lot of pictures and photos and description about how the measurement and judgment have to be done. Also, I would like to invite Mikhail to share his experience, the experience in welding.
Hi to everyone, do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So I'll share my screen and briefly show you how to compete in welding using the distributed form. Hopefully you can see my presentation. So first of all, I would like to say that it was a challenge for us to fit the rules of the new pandemic world, because welding is really realistic skill that you need to have this some kind of samples to measure, and you should measure carefully all the welds. We measure even 1/10 of millimeters, so you cannot just rely to the other experts or competitors and to let them measure all these aspects. That's why first of all we try to avoid the possibility to make the distributed or remote format. But anyhow, we decided that we should make the competition alive because otherwise we cannot make any welding competition this year. So we decided to make task a little bit easier compared to a regional one. So that is not because we tried to avoid additional job or work. That's because we decided that competitors should send the ready-made project to the assessment center. So we decided that a regional task should be too heavy and too should have too big dimensions. So it's not ecological and not modern way to hold the competition nowadays. So first module, if somebody knows welding, first module we decided to leave as it is. So welders will make all the same products in module one. And prepare them and seal them and send them to the assessment center. The module two and module three, so I have a mistype on the slide, but anyhow, aluminum module and stainless steel module will be made much more easier to avoid a big package that regions should send to the assessment center. So we just simplify them to the separate welds, separate joints. So anyhow, the assessment scheme will remain the same as usual. And how it will be? Now you can see the part of the drawing for the module one and real samples that competitors in regions will make on their own workplace. And after that, they will use the protective seal and send these samples to the assessment center. That was Rostec distributional corporational final. So one of Russian corporation decided to make such kind of competition, and we already make it alive, and we already made assessment. And this is one module one samples that we got from the competitors of this corporation. So after we got these samples, we start assessment. And also we use X-ray, so the independent laboratory for the X-ray testing. People make X-ray photographs of their lungs. The same we have in a welding, but we try to find the defects inside of the weld. Anyhow, the difference between the difference between original usual format of the competition and distributional format of the competition. We have minuses and the pluses. So one side of pluses, we have a possibility to let competitors think about on their own how to prepare the competition workplace for their own. So the competitors can think themselves how to prepare the best welding area that will help them and fit the rules of the competition. Here is the some samples of the tools that already competitors invent to prepare the backing gas isolation. So that will allow us to avoid original design of the stainless steel construction to the just simple weld construction. From my point of view, we have the minuses and the pluses. And in the minuses, first of all, will go the possibility to cheat, because in the original competition, experts, we have an independent experts and the chief experts and the skill manager on the venue. So these people can watch all the competitors. So we have not so many viewers. The competitors have some additional expenses to send the sample to the assessment center. We have expenses to prepare the samples. We have infrastructure, some difference in the infrastructure of the competitors, and sometimes not clear assessment. That is just one. This is just one one point of view for the distribution competition. From the another point of view, we have some valuable pluses. So we have as many competitors as will be ready to take part in the competition. Mainly, I'm not speaking about the existing national final. I'm speaking about the general possibility to have such kind of format of the competition. We have possibility to track, record, and review all the recordings from the CCTV cameras. So that will allow us to precisely assess some cheats. If competitors use in some cheats, we can just review the recording and check it once more time. We have cheaper competition organization. That's from my my point of view, because for the organization, for the host of the competition, it's much more easier to get some big screens that you can see behind me, and some good internet connection, and the ISP connection, and that's it. Developing local workplace and more safety. So that the last is not the least, because it's much more safe, because on the assessment center we have very few experts, the independent experts who will assess the sample. Later on I will briefly show you our venue, and all the competitors have maximum two or three people on their work side. So that's why we fit with this format to all the regulations regarding to the pandemic new world. So the next one is the way we decided to make the competition. So the competitor will prepare their welding booth, weld the samples, put the security seal on the camera, so we will see that real competitor do not change or cheat her own samples, and put the security seal before the sending the package to the assessment center. Then we have a few days for the delivery, and then the independent experts will check the ready-made samples. What actually experts do after, so that is the sample of how we hold the assessment. That was the Rostec competition. So you can see very few experts on the venue, but we fulfill the requirements of the World Skills assessment. So this final will do the same way. First of all, we can see the venue. I will stop my, okay. This is some screens that you will see later on. I will stop my demonstration and I will just describe what we have here. So we have several laptops on the run venue. Here is the workplace for the experts. The experts using the Zoom or other application to get in connection with the regions, with the competitors. Then we check all the infrastructure list of the all the competitors, so we can really be sure that all the competitors have the same welding equipment, same materials, same samples. So all the competitors have the same preparation. The next, we have a brief discussion of the safety. And the next, we let the experts and competitors have a good sleep and wait for the next day. So this is the first day we already finished. We checked all the venues. We checked all the security and safety regulations of the venues. We checked all of the PPE will be used for the next competition. Tomorrow, we will brief all the competitors and the experts again for the using the PPE and the safety. We will discuss the 30% change. And all this will be made by the cameras and the telecommunication, so video conference call. After that, competitors will start welding. Each competitor have several, roughly saying the five cameras. So we can check on the screens the different welding area. We have pretty much regions of, on our national final. That's why we have some small delays, but they're not so big. So we can see all the venues, all the from all the points of view. So we can see the face of the competitor, we can see the hands of the competitor, we can see all the venue, we can see precisely everything. And that's why we can be 100% sure that the competitor will not cheat and will send the real sample for us. I suppose mainly that's it. That's the most important for us. We didn't suppose that it will happen, but it is.
Thank you very much, Mikhail. It was also a really great experience for us to see the Competition Management Center, especially with all the screens and sensors that you explained how you're going to manage the sample which will be sent to you. And also we have cases when it's not just the finished complete test project, the final product will be sent to the centers. We have also the stories when we have to send materials for the competitors, that all the competitors will be in the same situation and will use the same materials. So in this case, we can measure the results and the result will be honest. So here we have Sergei. Sergei, are you with us? Sergei will share the experience. Like we have international guest competitors and also we have Eurasian countries who would like to have scoring and medal results together. So we have experience to send some materials and painting and decorating to our partner countries. Sergei, please, could you share your experience?
Yes, yes, Alina, colleague, and colleagues, I can show. Hello, dear colleagues, I am glad to welcome you, everyone. My presentation is about skills, independent skills assessment in the remote format using digital technologies. My competence, English not very well, but I try. If I not good, my colleagues help me. My education is a law degree and I have second education, it's MBA. But my experience in industry, I'm working for man paint production technologist, paint and decorators. Now I'm stakeholder several businesses. It's a paint factory and training center. And I'm organized some social project for street art and urbanistics city. And I have 5 years experience international expert for in Russia. My skills is paint of decorating. Experiences assessment. I have gained a lot of experience in international assessment in many countries and from experienced people.
Сереж, на секундочку, попробуй дозапустить презентацию, пока мы не видим.
А ты мне ее передала или вот Сергею Рыбкину?
Ты сам должен демонстрацию экрана запустить.
Я понимаю, но я сижу, вот мое лицо именно Discovery Skills. А презентацию запускай Сергей Рыбкин. Ну, запущено сейчас? Нет пока. О, отлично. Yes? It's okay? Нет. Запустил демонстрацию экрана. Sorry. Сейчас. Секунду.
We are sorry, just a minute. We are trying to open the presentation.
Пошла? О.
Да, пошла.
Yeah. Okay. Так, секунду. Степущая. Goals and experience. The goals of the reports, understanding the concept. I journal of 1,000 meals begins with single steps. Sharing experience of assessment in remove and distributing format and enjoying possible solution. Past experience, 3 years ago, try 3D scanners and gigapixel cameras, but we have some problem about a lot of expensive system. Even back they, when we have asked ourselves in this end, as VSI is first and foremost peoples. If assessment is automated, will it affect people's assessment skills and ability to further develop them? My competition is paint of decoration, 22 skills, and you see my aspects and my best project. We assess coloration quality, straight lines and straight corners, and gloss and cleanliness. And we have rules. Assessment takes place from a distance 1 meter, with regular lighting and time for assessment of each aspect is regulated. 19% measurement, but I'm not sure measurement is like objective, and 10% judgment. It's very strong. Understanding the problems, possible solution. Expensive digital solutions, 3D scanners and gigapixel cameras will make most of the assessment objective, but cannot be widely used because they are currently unaffordable price on quality. It's, price on quality is not good line. Inexpensive digital solution often cannot provide high quality objective results. WorldSkills Russia seek uniform standards. A standard in YSI, VSR, regional competitions, demonstration exam. An expensive solution won't work. At the moment of technology development, it would be optimal to switch from remove assessment to assessment by expert on site, remove control and responsibility for interference. Using a different approach when choosing control means based off assessment aspect. Problem. Everything during remove assessment. Assessment by video and photo, labeling, sending, receiving, and distributing files, using them for assessment. All this causing a lot of problems by to the difference. It's very, very expert, is very creative. Quality is equipment, shooting condition. Uniforms, shooting standards, labeling, signature, sending and receiving files. Uniform assessment, maintaining in the industrial standard, such as distance 1 meter, assessment times and editions so far. and we have some problem. Options for assessment, approach, and measurement. We run a test during the training simulation of the national competition. We have an interesting experiment, interesting experience in accordance with the CURTS uniform standards for shooting. Lighting, distance, time, and etc. Provided technical requirement and reference samples. Requirements for uniforms, filming equipment, and technical. Photo assessment, video assessment, video recording, and live assessment online stream video. Option for assessment, approach, and measurement. We run a test during the demonstration exam. Self assessment of assessment by the expert in the site using a multi-level control system. Minor changes to test project what would simplify remove assessment and will not go beyond the WorkSQ standard specification, technical description, or industry standard. 22 skills example, cutting wallpapers, with hand index, indent, and more. We need to switch from these formats to hard also depending on concert aspects. See example of the 22 skills. The principles of the system on-site assessment and control. Joint training, it's a very hard joint training. Expert on-site assessment all 100% and aspects area. And we have two level system control, but we can have three level system control and more. Each next level controls favor areas and aspects. Experienced controlling experts can always understand where mistake by assessing or previous controlling experts. What might by accident of the grounds to subjects interference. interference can be also defected and penalties are severe. I think it's a good system. We are all experts, but we need to have an image. Complex solution. Possible solution for remove assessment according to the current technology and skills development. Development of the on-site assessment and control system. Different approach to choosing methods. On-site assessment, photo, video, live stream for assessment of each aspects. And I set rules and trainings. It's a very apart. Yes, sorry. Development iterative process near future. Cyclist the system criteria produce and notes of VSI face-to-face assessment have been developed for decades. From iteration to iteration, and the same will be with the remote format. Cycle plan and implementation and control analysis and proposal and new plan. It's a cycle. Development iterative process future is 5, 10, and 15. Yes, progress does not stand still. Where value for money is improving gigapixel photo devices and 3D scanners, high resolution video cameras, VR, virtual reality, AR and MR reality, bonus with cameras. Programs what adjust image resolution to human. Etc. Problems itself are solution. There are always problems, but a journey of a profound miles begins with a single step, expensive when it is impossible not to take a step. I hope I have been able to help reduce cognitive dissonance and concepts by studying our experience in remove assessment and vision of further development. Sorry, my colleagues. Alexander Sergeyevich Pushkin said, how many blissful revelations the spirit of enlightenment hides. I'm sure what developing remove assessment is an important and interesting area of work what will bring use a lot. You think what the pandemic was shut the borders? I think all the country is has opening this entirely. New words for us. We can actively work, create projects, exchange knowledge and organize international joint lectures and training session and masterclass. But I have what they will meet face to face, shake hands, sit at the same table and learn new skills from each other. At the tips of your fingers. Thank you for your attention. Спасибо большое, коллеги. Thank you very much.
Сергей, thank you very much for sharing your experience.
I try.
You pointed quite a lot of very important key points. What is very important that we really need to train our experts and much more trainings that have to be done to arrange such kind of online remote assessments. And of course, that's what we are usually doing. We train our experts community and we train our masters. So if any of countries are interested in joint training, we are always ready to make the joint training for you. And now I would like to give the words to Alexander. He will share the experience of our IT skills. When we start our, when we switch to online formats, we have understanding that it will be possible only to make IT skills online. However, as you can see, we are managed with all other skills, but of course IT skills are in the most progress with online platform and with automated assessment system. So Alexander, could you share your experience, please?
Yeah, hi everyone. So can you hear me? Can you see the slides?
Yes. Но звук можно погромче чуть-чуть.
Just give me a second, please. I'll try to speak like a little bit louder. So can you now hear me?
Yes, better? Yes, it's better now.
Oh, it's better now. Okay. Okay. Hi everyone, so welcome on board, thank you for joining. So today I'm going to share some insights about the natural evolution of the IT skills competition. So, and speak a little about so how we move from the on-premises competition to the online. So just a couple of words about myself. I'm from the city called Tumen. This is in the middle of nowhere, Western Siberia. I'll show you in a map, like just in a couple of slides. So currently I'm the founder and I'm doing the role of the consulting engineer in the expert community called NSA Lab, so which stands for Network Systems Administration Lab. And as you can see, I have some pretty much of the world skills experience from the competitor side and from the expert side. So before we proceed, I just want everybody be on the same page in terms of some key definitions. So when we speak about the on-premises competition, so I think everyone is familiar with it because this is the most traditional way to organize this kind of events. So, and when we have the on-premises competition, so in this environment, the resources deployed in-house, so meaning right inside the competition venue. So when we speak about the remote competition, so we probably have the same people on the competition venue, or they might be distributed, but the key point that the resources are centralized and they are deployed somewhere off premises. So it can be a sort of the private cloud. So we will speak about cloud in a couple of slides. It might be some the other type of installation, but the key point is the major difference from the on-premises competition. When we do on-prem, so the experts on-site, the competitors on-site, all the equipment is on-site. So we don't have to do some sort of centralization in terms of the IT skills, right? When we do the remote one, remote competition, so we have to have all resources to be centralized in order to automate some provisioning and maybe the marking, all right? So, and when we speak about the online competition, so here is a bit different from the remote one. So when we do online, so the resources can be allocated and deallocated on demand using the public cloud providers. So we will speak about this difference a bit deeper in a minute. So, but before this, I just want to mention the definitions of the CapEx and OpEx, which stands for the capital expenditures, which are comprised of the major purchases that will be used in the future. So when we speak the CapEx, we probably mean that we are purchasing some hardware. So in terms of IT skills, it might be the from my point of view, so the IT network systems administration skills, we work a lot with the specialized equipment like networking equipment, and this is the major pain from the CapEx side. So, and we also have some operational expenditures, which are represent day-to-day costs, which are necessary. So it can be logistics, it can be a renting of space, the electricity. So everything that you do on day-to-day basis. So to contrast this definition, so this is the photo from the last year in Kazan from the international competition last year. So here we have, so this is Max. The Max was the workshop manager on the Skill 39 workshop. So, and on this photo, he had the four tracks of the equipment just dispatched. And so he actually going to start to build the whole workshop. So, and this is not the all equipment, right? So, because not all equipment can get into the photo, but the thing is the capital expenditure for the equipment, I mean, the major part, which is directly related to the TUS project. So the approximate cost was about $1.5 million on the general price list. So sounds a lot, right? And the thing is, this is the capital expenditures just for one event. So only just for international competition. So quite a lot of money, right? So, and imagine the time and effort which the workshop team managed to build this workshop and to deallocate this workshop after the competition. So it's quite a lot from the CapEx and from OpEx side as well. So how do we contrast this on-premises competition with the remote one? So me and my team, we had like last couple of years, pretty many cases of experience organizing the remote competitions. So here you can see the map with the countries. So this is the descriptions of the each event. So we had the remote competitions in Arab Emirates for WorldSkills Asia, national competitions in Germany, UK, some invitational competitions in China, the international Global Skills Challenge in Australia, national competition in Canada, even some corporate competition in India, national competition in Kazakhstan. And yes, so we had the remote competition experience, not for Skill 39, but for the cybersecurity last year in World Skills International in Russia. So here on the map, you can see the location of the private cloud, which were built by our team when we made the joint project with the university, which is the Tumen State University. So when we speak about the remote, so you remember the remote competitions in where you actually allocate resources off premises. So in each of these competitions, the competitors and experts, they were on premises on the competition side, but all their resources which are were required to do the test project or some module of test project, it might not be the whole competition, so they were dispatched off premises on the private cloud. So when we speak private cloud, so what does it really mean, the private cloud? So this is the how it was looking like under the hood. So this is the, it's not completely cloud, but this is the some sort of centralized solution for the organizing the Skill 39, which is the IT network systems administration and cybersecurity competitions occasionally. So you can see that this infrastructure takes a lot of effort, a lot of time to set up. So it's approximately, it took us approximately 1 year to set it up and make it run absolutely functionally, because you know the equipment costs money, logistics, some equipment not really compatible with the others, so that there was the problems with the initial design, so we had to redesign some parts. So it took us a lot of time, right? So actually, another thing, it requires the really qualified engineers to maintain. So if we have some event, right, in any other country, let's say UK, Germany, Canada, so of course we have to agree on the test project infrastructure in order to provision this infrastructure in advance and check that everything is working, everything can be deployed before the competition start. Otherwise we have a problems. But the key thing is, even if we have some events which we don't really expect, so for example in India, we were actually making the test project from scratch the night before the competition itself, because so the orgs were intent to do some different test projects. So people who actually went to this competition, I mean, from the other countries for the training for the cybersecurity, they were not really impressed with the topology and test project proposed by the orgs. So we actually committed to make the test project really quick and build the whole virtual infrastructure the one night before. And next day, about 12 a.m., it was actually ready. So it gives a lot of flexibility and possibility to create and scale the events to the a big amount of competitors. So the biggest one was actually the Indian competition, where we have, I don't remember exactly, but it was like 32 or 35 competitors we had in India. So you can see the project cost, and this is the only the CapEx. So this is the calculation only for the equipment. So it costs a lot of money, even less than the on the previous slide, I mean, the infrastructure for the international competition. And the thing is, you can reuse this infrastructure over and over again. So this is more, sounds like a CapEx, right? So this is sort of the long-term investment, but if you can see the project dates, so the project was started in December 2016, and the project was closed in December 2019. So last December it was closed. The university not really wanted to maintain this infrastructure, so it was disbanded. So 3 years actually with this cost is a lot better than the $1.5 million GPL for the 2 weeks international competition. But anyway, so this is not the way we want to go, actually. But before we proceed, so how do we actually estimate the amount of the resources and the infrastructure list for the either on-premises competition or the remote competition? So we have the basically two major numbers. So this is the amount of the resources that we have or which we expect from the sponsors or the skill partners. And we have some amount of competitors. So how many competitors we expect. So we divide the number of the expected resources to the number of the expected competitors. And we can say, so this is the amount of test project resources that we can actually give to the each competitor to make to set up the competition, right? So this is not the way that we want to actually run the competition, because we have the circumstances when we don't want to be, let's say, limited to the amount of the resources, and we have the possibility to scale up really quickly. So how do we use this estimation in online competition? So we actually having the same number, how many competitors do we expect, but instead of saying or thinking how many resources do we have, so we actually name the minimum amount of the test project resources that we need for the one competitor or one team. And so as a result of this multiplication, we have the total amount of the resources that we need to request from where. So the public cloud providers coming into play, and how is it possible, right? So we actually don't have anymore the physical infrastructure, the physical devices, the physical computers. I mean, we do have to have the PCs, right, or laptops to access the infrastructure. But the key point is we don't need to spend money and have any big capital expenditures on the compute power or GPU power or anything else which costs a lot of money, right? So here is the some simple representations how we can do the test project infrastructure as a code. So the experts actually, they define the number of competitors. They have to create some test project template. It depends on the cloud provider that we are using, actually. So in our experience, so we are actually using the AWS and the Microsoft Azure, but there are a lot of the cloud providers, so you can actually use any of them, which is more suited to your test project or your skill infrastructure needs. So the experts actually just telling the cloud provider using the automatic programming application programming interface, so please give me these number of the test project templates, meaning the resources, the virtual machines, the containers, or any other types of infrastructure that you need. So cloud provider just silently give you the amount of resources which actually you requested, because the clouds are built for really huge enterprises, and the test project load for the some sort of IT competition is not a big load for the cloud provider. So we can actually sort of say that we have unlimited amount of the resources, the capacity. So after we close the event, so we had the test project deployed for any number of competitors that won. So we held the competition, so we got the marks. So we don't really need these resources anymore. So we just telling the cloud provider, please deallocate these resources. So we don't need them anymore. And cloud provider just deallocates their resources. And the cloud provider, after usually in the end of the billing period, which is the end of the month or the start of the next month, they just send you the bill for the amount of resources that you used, meaning if you're using the, let's say, one virtual machines and you have like 12 competitors, and for the test project, overall, for the 12 competitors, you have to have some 12 virtual machines, and you need it for, let's say, 5 hours. So the bill in the end of the months of the billing period will be sent you only for these 12 virtual machines used for 5 hours. So meaning that you don't have to rent the equipment, you don't have to rent the servers, you don't have to rent anything like for a month, or buy it for years and pay for the logistics, the space, the electricity, etc. So of course, it requires some qualification from the experts, right? So, and the experts should follow the some core principles, like storing the configuration, meaning the test project infrastructure templates in version control systems like Git, using the GitHub or GitLab or whatever platform they prefer. So they have to use and at least be familiar with some machine readable formats or languages like YAML, JSON, or old fashioned XML or whatever, right? So everyone who working with this infrastructure, I mean, so we can have the number of experts and they all should need and treat the version control system as the only source of the truth, right? So meaning, editing and like modifying some the templates locally on the laptops is not going to work with this sort of the infrastructure. So all changes and all modifications should be version control and centralized as well. So meaning that we can develop, we can test, we can deploy the test project infrastructure from a single source. So, and we have to be familiar. So because the cloud providers, they usually provide in the same types of the service, but the APIs, I mean, the programming interfaces, they are different from the cloud provider to the cloud provider. So you have to be familiar, I mean, the experts should be familiar with the differences on the APIs and specialized tools which are used on the selected cloud provider. So meaning that we don't have to use any manual configuration of the infrastructure. So everything should be automated as possible. So can we actually expand these principles to the marking? So we actually can. So it depends on the number of factors. And the first question that rises when we speak about the automated assessment in IT skills is, do we really need the assessment to be automated? So it really depends on the situation, right? So if you have like not big number of the competition events and they are like small scale, you have like sort of 5, 8, or maybe 12 competitors. So does it really take the time and the cost of your effort to make the all the marking automated? Probably not. So, but when you have the events on the regular basis, when you have big, really big scale, when you have like 10, 20, 30, 40 competitors. So it really makes sense to make the assessment framework automated as much as possible. But of course, we have some pros and cons, right? If we will contrast the manual and automated marking in terms of the time. So of course, the manual marking takes more time than the automated marking. If we speak about in the competition. So of course the automated marking takes a lot of time to design before the competition. So, but here we speak about after the competition finished, right? So when we speak about the granularity, so manual marking cannot be that granular as the automated marking, of course. So for example, so you can refer to the marking scheme aspect. So make sure that the every user can log into a corporate domain or the website. So what if we have only 10 users required to log into the domain or the website? So we can actually do the granular marking for the 10 users. But what if we have like 100 users or 1,000 users, 10,000 users? So we are not going to check every of the 10,000 users manually, right? So yeah, here we can actually make the demarking more granular with the automated marking. So in terms of complexity, of course, the manual marking is not really complex because, so all you have to do is should be enough, I mean, in terms of space and complexity, which you can place to the marking scheme or how to mark. So, and of course, automated marking is might be really complex. So it depends on the test project. And people who actually, like different experts who are not designing this automated marking, it may take a lot of time and effort to understand the whole marking script and what they do, what they don't do. So it really may be really complex, and we will speak about a little bit later. So, and the complexity comes to transparency. The less marking complex, so it more transparent, right? So when we have a long, like hundreds of lines script of the automated marking, so it becomes not really transparent, which is the first reason for the experts to reject these types of automated marking. But the most actually valuable point is the automated marking has the lower probability of the injustice error. So imagine you have a competition for 30 or 40 competitors who are doing the test project simultaneously, and you have to go through the all of these 40 competitors and assess the same things. So the experts, they are humans, right? So they can be tired, they can miss some insignificant parts which can actually be more significant than they think. So, and when we have a big scale of the competition, so it's more highly likely to have injustice error when the experts doing the manual marking, because even if we have some errors or mistakes in the automated marking scripts, they will be the same for everyone. So if somebody got the zero because something is wrong with the marking script, everyone will get zero. So this is the major takeaway from the automated assessment. So, and how can we actually make the automated marking more transparent and less complex? So it requires the redesign of the test projects and redesign of the assessment criteria, because currently I saw a lot of cases when actually, through the practical skills demonstration, experts require competitors to demonstrate the exam knowledge. So, meaning if you know some tips and tricks which are assessed in the some sort of certification blueprint, so please show me how do you like do it in the practice. And this is the wrong way to have. So the right way to go is to use the functional assessment of the business value result. So as an example, in Skill 39, the IT Network Systems Administration, we usually have a lot of connectivity tests. Like, let's say we have some requirement in the test project. So please ensure that the users in the headquarters office have the internet connectivity. So instead of checking how competitor configured this internet connectivity, we should actually assess that the connectivity exists no matter how it is achieved, but the business value is to have the connectivity to the internet or the to the different corporate branches or whatever. I hope you got the idea. So, and if we will redesign the test project requirements and the assessment criteria to include only the functional assessment, so automated marking can be much, much more easier and more transparent. So this is just an example of the testing, how actually can the automated provision can be achieved. So the one more thing about the automated marking assessment is to you have to really have the means to test your marking, your automated marking. So the thing is, you can imagine, right? The test project, the test project module is actually 5 hours. So to test every version of the automated assessment script, so you have to complete the test project over and over and over again. So you have to make some sort of the automated implementation of the test project. So here's just the example when we have the all infrastructure for the Skill 39 Module C virtualized. And since we are implementing the core principles that we talked about a couple of slides earlier, so we can actually not only programmatically deploy the infrastructure, we can also automatically implement the test project. And after that, we can automatically assess the test project. So this is the only examples, but I hope you got the idea, right? So speaking of the IT competitions, IT skills that can actually use the same methodology, I think it can be applied almost for all IT skills, not only the Skill 39 IT Network Systems Administration. So of course we have cloud computing. So, and this is the coincidence that today, I think 17 minutes ago, so we finished the AWS game day. So this is not the final result. So I made this screenshot like hour before the presentation. So, and because the cloud computing is the cloud native skill, of course they do have automatic means to deploy the infrastructure and assess the result of the test project. So here is just an example of the event engine that AWS using for the assessment of the teams, actually. So it's pretty much real world, so I can say, because the test project objectives is to like migrate the infrastructure from the on-premises environment to the cloud environment with minimal downtime. And you actually have do a lot of things like security, auto-scaling, a lot of things, right? And the assessment is actually ongoing. So it's really online. So you can see the timing on the left. So a few seconds ago, 3 minutes ago, so they constantly testing, and the teams got the score on the scoreboard. So this is not really a world skills event. So this is just the just an example how the competition, the professional qualification audit can be assessed on the online, of course. So this is the cloud computing, right? So, but we also have the web technologies, IT solutions for business, graphical engineering, CAD, right? So these competitions, these skills require really only the computational power. So, and there is no need to make it CapEx, right? So we can actually transform the capital expenditures when we bind the hardware, the servers, the other equipment to the operational expenditures when we actually just require the amount of resources. So we use the resources, we deallocate the resources, and we pay only for the resources that we use in the time we use, right? So in the end, so this is more about the cultural transformation, right? Because I know a lot of experts in IT who actually don't know what is the cloud, how to use the cloud, and they really like to dealing with the real hardware equipment, but this is not really way to go, because we are in 2020, right? So we have the circumstances which are not very friendly to this kind of events, and so we have to move forward. But the key takeaways is to please stop invest in the hardware. Please start invest to the people, your people. So this is all for today. Thank you so much. So please feel free to drop me a line using the email, Facebook, or Telegram. I will just copy the my contacts to the chat. So, and this is all for today for me. I will pass it back to Alina. Thank you.
Thank you, Alexander. So we can see that IT skills already ahead. So they're not just talking, we are not just talking about how to make assessment just in online format. We are finding the way how to make assessment out in automated way. And also what we have mentioned here that you see that all skills actually need this transparent digital skills. So IT skills now, in we can see that IT skills can be part of each skill. From one point, it could be like part of competition task, and from another hand, we can use IT technology and digital technology for assessment. So thank you everyone who joined us. Sorry that it takes more time for today. However, I think that information was really useful. Also, we would like to share with you all the scale of different kind of skills, how it's possible to run competition and how it's possible to run assessment. So we hope that you get inspiration for your countries. If you have any questions, you can write this question on the email. And based on our program, tomorrow we will discuss how vocational education system and how business support skills competition with this new formats. And also, if you're interested in more detailed information regarding few skills, also check the program and attend meetings and workshops according to. Thank you everyone, and see you tomorrow and next days.
Bye everyone, see you tomorrow.
Bye, thank you for the invitation.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you very much, see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.